All right, now in this scenario, you're gonna have a patient with a suspected stroke. You're an ACLS team leader who has a 70-year-old female patient. Her friend said that she was watching television when she started to feel weak, and she suddenly had some difficulty speaking, and her left side became very weak. When her friend tried to help her stand up, she was unable to walk on her own. The patient is conscious and breathing normally, but appears agitated. As you ask your patient questions, she has difficulty speaking and giving appropriate answers. Your patient's friend said she noticed the difficulty speaking about 30 minutes ago. Now, because the initial signs indicate a possible stroke, you should perform a stroke assessment. Pre-hospital providers might perform an abbreviated assessment known as the Cincinnati Pre-Hospital Stroke Assessment. It consists of facial droop, arm drift, speech, and time. In hospital providers, they might perform a more detailed full NIH stroke score to document neurological status. In our patient's assessment, we found that she is conscious and alert. However, the patient does have facial droop, left arm drift, and speech difficulty. This is enough information to call for the stroke team to respond and order an emergency CAT scan. Now, the next step is to get a set of vitals. You direct a team member to place the BP cuff and O2 sat monitor. The team member tells you that the pulse is 78, respirations are 18, and she has a blood pressure of 124 over 100. The skin is warm and dry, but the O2 sat is 96%. Based on the vital signs, the patient does not need oxygen. At this time, you would attach the monitor and get a 12-lead EKG. As you look at the 12-lead printout, you see a normal sinus rhythm. You direct a team member to continue checking the blood pressure every 5 minutes and keep a close eye on any changes in her breathing. An important diagnostic tool for potential stroke is blood glucose. Hypoglycemia or low blood glucose can mimic stroke symptoms such as confusion and slurred speech. You direct the assistant to check the glucose level and it's normal at about 90. In order to consider fibrinolytic therapy, we need to determine the time since symptoms started. And since she arrived at the emergency room, it's been just about 15 minutes. The symptoms started 30 minutes before arriving to my care. So now, since the patient's blood pressure, O2 sat, and glucose levels are within normal limits, and the symptoms started less than 3 hours ago, this patient may be a good candidate for RTPA. If the patient has no history of previous strokes, is not on blood thinners or other contraindicated medications or other contraindications, then the CT scan will be the determining factor. If the CT scan shows no hemorrhage, we'll be able to go with RTPA. To be ready for this potential drug therapy, this is the time to start an IV. You direct the assistant to start an IV 18-gauge antecubital with normal saline. We're going to keep this at a TKO rate. The goal is to recognize potential stroke signs early and get the patient appropriate fibrinolytic therapy or the most appropriate reperfusion strategy in a timely manner.